Tuberculosis, TB, is an infectious disease caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis. TB most commonly affects the lungs, however, can spread to other parts of the body, including the heart, bones, liver, and kidneys. Multidrug-resistant tuberculosis occurs when a strain develops resistance to two of the most potent first-line anti-tuberculosis drugs. Tuberculosis is spread via airborne droplets. TB can be suspended in the air for minutes. Once the droplets are inhaled, the particles lodge in the bronchioles and alveoli. Local inflammation occurs. Transmission requires close, frequent, or prolonged exposure. TB is not spread by touching, sharing utensils, kissing, or other physical contact. Diagnostic studies. Tuberculin skin test. The Mantu test. If induration is present, this does not mean you have TB. Just that you have been exposed to the bacteria and further testing is required. For low-risk individuals, it is positive if the induration is greater than or equal to 15 millimeters. For high-risk individuals, it is positive if the induration is greater than or equal to 10 millimeters. And for immunocompromised patients, it is positive if the induration is greater than or equal to 5 millimeters. Following the TST test, a chest x-ray must be done. This cannot make the diagnosis solely for tuberculosis. After the chest x-ray, the patient will undergo bacteriologic studies, including a sputum culture. Sputum samples are obtained on 2 to 3 consecutive days, preferably in the morning. The stained sputum smears are sent to the lab to be examined for acid-fast bacilli. This will be the golden standard for diagnosing tuberculosis.
Help, help, I've fallen and I can't get up.
Higher, there's one not far from here. isoniazid. Make sure to complete your treatment for the prescribed length of time from 6 to 9 months, depending on your doctor. There is a black box warning to avoid alcohol and reduce consumption while on the medication because it can cause hepatotoxicity. Some other adverse effects you might have are peripheral neuropathy, thrombocytopenia, paresthesia, anemia, seizures, dizziness, muscle aches, GI distress, dry mouth, urinary retention, and jaundice. When you are taking it orally, make sure to take it on an empty stomach, which means 1 hour before meals or 2 hours after. And it does deplete your vitamin B6, so make sure that you are on supplementation. Patients need to come in to check the AST and the ALT levels when they first start taking it and monthly thereafter, and then also make eye appointments at the ophthalmologist to get your eyes checked monthly. And of course, make sure not to forget to finish taking the full course of medication to get rid of that TB.
Go to all of your planned doctor's visits. Alcohol use may cause side effects. Tell your doctor about any other medications that you're on. And some people find relief from medication effects when the medication is taken with food. It is a daily medication that you take, possibly for 4 months, depending on your TB. You're going to want to take it the same time every day, setting an alarm, or maybe having a family or friend remind you, or even putting notes on the refrigerator. Possible adverse side effects are going to be loss of appetite, severe weakness and tiredness, nausea and vomiting. You can have cola-colored urine or light stools, dizziness, head or body ache. And if you miss the dose during that day, you can take it again, or you can take your dose, but do not take 2 doses at one time.
Thank you.
final medication is ethambutol. Ethambutol should be used in conjunction with other anti-TB medications during the intensive phase, which is about 8 weeks for 40 to 56 doses. Some warnings and contraindications include hypersensitivity, optic neuritis, which is a risk versus benefit decision, use in young children, unconscious patients, or patients unable to discern or report visual changes. Major side effects include optic neuritis, GI upset, confusion, renal excretion of uric acid, peripheral neuropathy, renal damage, and thrombocytopenia. There are no black box warnings for this drug. During the period of treatment, you must go in for a baseline and monthly visual testing on patients receiving more than 15 milligrams per kilogram per day. Baseline and monthly renal, hepatic, and hematopoietic tests should be conducted in all patients. This medication may be taken with food if GI upset occurs.
That Gus came up, and that is.
You already started. We'll need to cut that. Here's a little about